of all, let me congratulate my friend on my right side, Pradeep Kumar Kunche, who has brought up this vision document. It is a vision document, and this young man, to me, it appears that not only that he is an activist, but somewhere I feel down the line that he is also a person who has seen what is happening in society. Since he says that he has come from a rural area, I believe he is also some kind of a whistleblower for some time. As far as his book is concerned, maybe that I won't be able to do full justice because I got the book just a day before. But I had gone through some passages of the book. All my appreciation for the vision document, because Kunche has tried to cover each and everything which he feels is needed for good governance. That is the great thing about his book. Nevertheless, there are certain things which I would actually agree only to disagree with him. I have gone through some of his letters. He has written 8 letters to the Honorable Prime Minister. And his letters are very bold. And the topic of the book is Scared to Answer Means Absolute Scared. It's a good title. Now, when I went through some of his letters, I think first 3 or 4 letters, Mr. Kunche, these are about the failure of demonetization. I do not know what you think about demonetization. I think I would be the lone man in this room who actually was in favor of demonetization. And I think when Prime Minister Modi announced in 2016 that these notes would just be useless by the next morning, that is, they won't be tendering any money, 500 and 1,000 rupee notes. I think he had a vision. Unfortunately, what happened was, let us actually appreciate that this man who had been traveling all over the world, to France, to USA, to Australia, to Germany, in his heart of heart, he also wants to make India not only like one of those countries, but a country better than those countries. He is an honest man. He means business. However, what I lament is, and this is something very critical, I wish that all his ministers, all his members of parliament, actually, they were like him. He works for 20 hours a day, right? He's not into minting money, all these things. I think his ministers and his MPs should learn from him. That is where slightly, the party went wavered. I am a person who is not carrying anybody's brief, nor BJP, neither BJP's brief, nor Congress. I say whatever I think is the right thing. Maybe I am wrong to some of you. So far as demonetization is concerned, yes, there were problems. There were problems of printing the 500 rupee notes in advance, 2,000 rupee notes in advance. There were problems. Many people lost their lives. So I even suggested to the government, when people gave all their money, when the money was deposited into banks, something like 14 lakh crore rupees or 15 lakh crore rupees, whatever it was, I suggested to Jaitley ji that since this money has come back to the banks, this is fake money or rotten money or black money, whatever it is, announce some schemes for the poor, right? For the ones who are left out. Anyway, these are the people who run the show, who run the government. Maybe they are bigger minds. But this is what I suggested, that after having collected this huge amount of money, something should have been given to the poor public. Now, I would like to mention something from his letter number 5. In letter number 5, Kunche talks about reservations. It seems, if I am not wrong, Pradeep, somewhere you are in favor of reservations about certain sections of society. I am one person, I come from Muslim community, right? In fact, a huge chunk of my own community is very poor. But despite that, I would not go in for reservation. Because reservation is nothing. It is just like a begging bowl, right? What happens is, let us work hard. Once, I'll tell you something very interesting. I had a debate, a heated argument with Mr. Antule. Antole Saab used to be the first, I think, minority minister of India. He, what happened was, I filed PIL against Jamia, you must be knowing, that it should not be a minority institution. In fact, I became very unpopular within my own community, but I knew whatever I was doing was perhaps for a larger vision. So he said, you take this case back. I said, why? He said, no, you know, Muslims are backward, they have to be given some bit of reservation. I asked him one thing, look here, Mr. Antule, you are a bar at law, you are a very learned person, capable person. You also became, if I am not wrong, he also became the chief minister of Maharashtra. He also became minister. I asked him, have you ever taken any reservation in any form? He said, no. So, you know, I differ from you, Kunche. The other thing, one thing which I liked about your vision document is that you have even mentioned, you know, that there should be, you know, something for poor people where they should get fresh vegetables, they should get pulses, all these things at the right price. All this is, I think, fine. And also your treatise on health. You have done a very hard work on this. Undoubtedly, you have burned the midnight oil working for all these documents. But let me suggest you one thing, right? That is, you have taken up each and everything, whether it is demonetization, whether it is Swachh Bharat, whether it, you know, there are almost 50 topics. What you do is, you also, you know, went to Congress, maybe, you know, you worked there for some time, but they did not take up your document to be involved, you know, in their government on a larger parameter. You also went to the BJP government, they also liked it, they also involved you for some time for this Niti Aayog. What you do is, you select some topics, say not more than four, 2 to 4. You work hard on those and you create, further you bring another book or you work on those. And I believe, let me tell you one thing, this Prime Minister, he is a very responsive Prime Minister. I am not saying because, he has become my friend. First time I met him in 2015. How I actually got to know him, I just wrote an email to him, thinking, chalo bhai, aise likh dete hain, nothing is going to happen. After a couple of days, I received a phone call that the Prime Minister wants to meet you. I just wrote a letter, I met him. I found that this man is a man of heart. He is a man who is a warm-hearted man. And he wants to do something, he wants to take India to dizzy heights. This is what my conclusion about this man is. Mr. Josh, while he was speaking about this government, about Modi ji, to me it appeared that he was delivering his vision document for the Congress. I wish his party and him good luck. Whatever he said, there was sense in it. But once again, let me tell you that I beg to differ with you, and whatever loopholes, whatever lacunae, yes, these are there. You talked about Swachh Bharat, nothing has been done. You talked about reservations, nothing. People are very poor, people are not getting their square meal. I agree with you. But also remember, Josh Saab, that this is the working of the 70 years of your own party. So, you know, Modi is trying his level best. What can he do within 5 years, 4.5 years, right? Once again, let me tell you, I am very honest. I am known to him, but I am not carrying his brief or the brief of RSS or BJP. What I wish is that all the leaders, especially in his own party, they follow him, they walk into his shoes, and India will be a country what Josh Saab wants it to be. And finally, before I take leave, I think I got carried.
Mr. Josh was not stopped.
See, ma'am, whatever was spoken before me, it was all political.
Madam, sorry, you can't speak.
Josh Saab,
let it. No, you can't interview.
You should have asked.
You can't interview.
Yeah, I'm sitting here.
No, no, it's not only you.
Listen to me.
It is us, Lord, also.
Please, one more thing. Please, listen to me.
No, 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 listen to me.
Order, please, order, let him.
Just let me take leave.
Kindly finish fast.
No, no, please, ma'am. If I offended you, I can apologize.
No, no, it is not.
Listen to me.
May I take a minute?
Just a minute.
How can you stop? How can you stop? Ask. No, no, how can you stop other speaking?
Please, ma'am, let me tell you one thing, please, let me tell you one thing, listen, listen.
Hold on, hold on.
Listen.
Why he shouldn't speak your language?
No, it's all right. I am speaking nobody's language.
Have patience.
I am speaking my own language.
It is not good. Sorry.
Please, please. Let me finish.
Whatever, I am inviting. I am one of the inviting.
Please, let me finish, ma'am.
No, this is not good.
No, let me finish.
This is called indiscipline.
Let it be a book release. Let it not be living a platform.
And Mr. Joshua making a book release, you are filling the book.
Please, let me finish.
Was that a book release? That was a speech too. You can stop that.
Mr. President, I would like to know what is the locus standi of these people who are here in the club to create chaos? Who invited them?
Is it your club? It is your club only?
Who has invited them?
You are one of the members. You are one of the members.
Same thing.
You are not the entire club. You are not the entire club.
It's restricted entry. Who has invited them?
You are only.
Can we have peace?
You are one vote. You are one vote.
I have no vote. I have no vote.
Hello.
I don't vote.
Ma'am, please bear with me.
I just don't vote.
Ma'am, just a minute.
So who has invited them? I would like to know.
Who has invited you?
They are all our honored
guests. Who has invited you?
They are all our
honored guests. I remember, I have locus standi, you have none.
Ma'am, please, please hold down.
You must.
Let me make it clear.
Hello. No, no, please.
Very stalled down, ma'am.
See,
what is the club becoming?
Ma'am, you are a lady, we respect you, please.
No, no, that's all right. It is restricted entry, it is restricted.
Please sit down, please sit down. We'll give you an opportunity to speak. Let me finish. Let me finish. Finally, last few words.
Book is not for the members.
Finally, last few words. Last few words. See, I am not a political animal, and
kindly conclude, Mr. Buck. Please finish.
I'm concluding.
Thank you.
See, to conclude, silence, please. Please silence. I beg for your attention, please. To conclude, let me tell you, my grandfather, Maulana Azad, was my grandfather's younger brother, Maulana Ghulam Yaseen's younger brother. So what he said once, he was a great writer. He was a visionary, he was a freedom fighter, he was all in one. But what he said was that politics is a dirty game. I do not know why he said this. But, you know, I also beg to differ with him. Why? Because whether politics is a good game or a dirty game or a filthy game, whatever it is part of our lives. We have to manage with it, we have to live with it. What matters is that we have to be honest people, we have to be honest. Again, please don't say that I am politicizing. We have to
Thank
be
you.
Honest like
Thank
our
you.
Prime Minister. Finally, let me tell you one more thing. As far as the vision is concerned, the vision of this book is on the lines of Maulana Abul Kalam Azad, who was a true son of
Thank
India.
You. Thank you.
And finally, last word. Koi gaye ki baat hai everything. Let me tell you one thing, Josh Saab. Ek meri do lines se main end karunga. You said that people are being divided on certain things, jhatka ghosh. I don't think this thing is happening in India. India is a very peaceful country, and Maulana Azad said that India is Darul Aman. It is a land of peace. Aur aakhir mein ek mera sher hai, usse main khatam karunga. Koi mushkil nahi hai Josh sahab, khas taur pe aap mere bhai hain, bade bhai hain. Aapse bahut kuch seekha hai maine, Sapru House mein bahut sunta tha aapko. Koi mushkil nahi hai Hindu ya Musalman hona. हाँ बड़ी बात है इस दौर में इंसान होना।
थैंक यू।
नेशनल दस्तक को देखने वालों से अपील है कि वह नेशनल दस्तक के सपोर्टर फॉर्म को भरें ताकि हम सीधे आपसे जुड़ सके।
नेशनल दस्तक की आपसे गुजारिश है कि अगर इसको बचाना चाहते हैं तो नेशनल दस्तक को सब्सक्राइब करने के लिए रेड कलर के सब्सक्राइब बटन को दबाएं, फिर बेल आइकन की घंटी दबाएं। नेशनल दस्तक को बचाने के लिए बहुत जरूरी है कि हर खबर को शेयर करें, लाइक करें, कमेंट जरूर करें।